dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. In yesterday's lecture we have seen the types of fractions. Okay, so today we are going to solve the examples which are based on those types of fraction. We have seen the types of fraction like unit fractions, proper fractions, improper fractions. Also we have seen mixed fractions, right? And after that we have learned conversion of improper fraction into mixed fraction and vice versa, means mixed fraction into converge improper fraction. Okay, so see here practice 5.9, which is based on these concept types of fraction that we are going to solve today. See the first question. Open your textbook. The first two questions you write in the textbook only. Okay, so see the first question in the practice 5.9 is, see here, say which of the following are proper and which of the following are improper fraction, give reason. So directly write in the notebook only. Practice 5.9, write in the notebook. Okay, see the first question. Say which of the following are proper and which of the following are improper fraction. Means some examples are given here and we have to identify whether that fraction is proper fraction or improper fraction. See here, first example is 13 upon 9, then 11 upon 19, 12 upon 5, 8 upon 17. So these are the given fraction and we have to identify whether they are proper fraction or improper fraction. Now remember, if you remember yesterday while learning types of the fraction, I have told you what is mean by proper fraction and improper fraction, or how to identify whether the given fraction is proper or improper. Okay, so first we revise proper fraction. Proper fraction means what? The fraction having the numerator smaller than the denominator. If the numerator is smaller than its denominator, then that fraction is proper. Whereas improper fraction means the fraction having its numerator greater than the denominator. Okay, now see the first, in the first fraction, 13 upon 9. See, the numerator is 13, denominator is 9. 13 is greater than the 9, right? Means this numerator is greater than the denominator. Then which fraction?
Yes,
it is improper fraction. So write here improper fraction, because they have asked to write reason also. So write here because the numerator is greater than denominator. Okay, in short I have written the numerator is greater than denominator, so it is improper fraction. Now see next one, 11 upon 19. Here 11 is numerator which is smaller than denominator, so which fraction it is?
Proper fraction,
because why it is proper fraction? Because numerator is smaller than denominator. Numerator, when numerator is smaller than denominator, then it is proper. And when numerator is greater than denominator, at that time it is improper fraction. Okay. See then 12 upon 5. Here numerator is greater or smaller than denominator?
Yes, it is greater, so it is improper fraction.
Okay,
improper fraction,
because numerator is greater than denominator. Okay. Here 8 upon 17, it is proper fraction because numerator is smaller. Proper fraction because numerator is smaller than denominator. Numerator is smaller than denominator. Okay? So in this way the question will be to identify whether the given fraction is proper or improper and why. Give reason. And you write answer in this way. Question 2. This was question 1. Question 2. See question number 2. Write the following as mixed fraction. Write the following as mixed fraction. First one, 7 and 1 third. As we have learned yesterday, mixed fraction means what? Three and two thirteen. That is 2 upon 13. 11 and 9 upon 11. And 3 plus 2 7. Okay. So this fraction we have to write as a mixed fraction. You know, mixed fraction means there is whole part and fractional part. Okay? So that is called mixed fraction. So here 7 and 1/3. In the 7 and 1/3, which is whole part? In the 7 and 1/3, which is whole part? 7. So write 7 here. And 1/3, that is 1 upon 3. Okay, similarly here 3 and 2/3. 3 and 2/3 means 3 is whole part and 2/13 is fractional part. So 3 and 2/13 means 3 whole, 2 upon 13. Okay, then 11 and 9 upon 11. So 11 is whole part. 11 whole, 9 upon 11. Here 3 plus 2 upon 7. So here also see whether though there is plus sign, 3 is whole part because 3 is complete. In that 3, we have to add 2 7. So when we add 2 7 in the 3, what we get? 3 whole 2 upon 7. Understood? So these are the mixed fraction for the given fractional number. Now see question number 3. Write this in your notebook immediately. Pause the video and write this in your notebook. Okay? Then see question number 3. Turn your page. Question number 3. Express each of the following as mixed fraction. Express each of the following as mixed fraction. Means which fraction we can express in the mixed fraction? Which fraction? Yesterday we have seen conversion of which fractions into mixed fraction? Improper fraction. So the given fractions are improper. See that numerator is greater. So the given fractions are improper fraction. We have to convert them into mixed fraction. Okay. And question 4 also I will write here. Question 4 is express each of the following as an improper fraction. Means they have given mixed fraction and we have to convert mixed fraction into improper. Okay, now see. First, we will solve question number 3 in which they have given improper fraction which we have to convert into mixed fraction. Okay, now see 17 upon 7. 17 upon 7, as I told you yesterday, improper fractions are one of the form of mixed fraction. Okay, improper fractions are one of the form of mixed fraction. So we can convert improper fraction into mixed fraction. Remember, we cannot convert
proper fractions into mixed fraction. We can convert only improper fraction into mixed fraction. Now, how to convert? See, 17 upon 7. This, the meaning of this is also 17 divided by 7. Okay? So, let's divide 17 by 7. Okay? So, 7 on the 7, 7 2s are 14, 7 3s are 21. 21 is greater than 17, so we will not say table of 7 is 21. Here we get 21. We will say here, 7 2s are 14. Okay? Subtract 14 from 17. 7 minus 4, 3, 1 minus 1, 0. Finish? Now, as I told you yesterday, here the quotient which we have obtained here, the quotient we have to take as a whole power. The quotient is 2, that will be our whole power. 2 whole. Then, in the fractional part, remainder take in the numerator. Okay, remainder take in the numerator and the divisor in the denominator. That is 2 whole. 3 upon 7 is the mixed fraction for the 17 upon 7. Okay, what we have done? 17 upon 7 means 17 divided by 7. So we divided 17 by 7, we got quotient 2 and remainder 3. So quotient will be your whole part, and in the fractional part, the remainder will be numerator and divisor will be denominator. Okay? Visualize that so that you will keep it in mind also. If you have understood the concept very well. Now see, 21 divided by 10. 21 upon 10 means 21 divided by 10. Let's divide 21 by 10. 10 ones are 10, 10 twos are 20. 1 minus 0, 1, 2 minus 2, 0. So your remainder is 1. How will be your mixed fraction? What will take as a whole part? Quotient. Okay, the quotient is 2. It will be your whole part. Then in the fractional part, remainder take in the numerator and divisor will be taken as a denominator. So the mixed fraction for 21 upon 10 is 2 whole 1 by 10. Finish? So in this way we can convert mixed fractions, improper fraction into mixed fraction. In the question number 4, let's learn, let's practice to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. Now see, here mixed fractions are given 4 whole 1 by 3. This mixed fraction we have to convert into improper. How to convert? I told you yesterday. Yes, whole part multiply by denominator plus numerator upon denominator. Okay? Whole part means this 4. Multiply with the denominator plus numerator upon the denominator. Okay, so see, what is whole part here? 4. Multiply by denominator. Denominator is 3 plus numerator. Numerator is 1 upon denominator. Denominator is 3. Okay? Is equal to 4 3s are 12 plus 1 upon 3. That is 13 upon 3. 13 upon 3 is the improper fraction for the given mixed fraction, that is for whole 1 by 3. Next, 5 whole 2 by 3. Again, which formula? Whole part into denominator plus numerator upon denominator. Okay? This formula you have to use to convert mixed fraction into improper fractions. Now see here, what is whole part? 5 into denominator 3 plus numerator is 2 upon denominator. Denominator is 3. Okay? So 5 3s are 15 plus 2 upon 3. 15 plus 2 17
upon 3. 17 upon 3 is the fractional, improper fraction for the given mixed fraction. Okay. Hope you understood. Pause this video. Write this in your notebook. After that, we will solve next question. See now, the next question number 5 is again they have given question examples for the comparing of fraction, comparison of fraction. See, compare the following. Question number 5. Compare the following. So see, first one, 3 by 4 and 5 by 6. B, 4 by 7 and 8 by 30. C and D you will solve by yourself. Now see, comparison of fraction we have learned, right? Three types of comparison we have learned, that is when denominators are same, when numerators are same, and when denominators and numerators are totally different. So here if you observe these fractions, these fractions come in the third category, that is the numerators and denominators are different. So when numerators and denominators are different, at that time which method we use to compare? Cross multiplication method. Okay, so see, cross multiplication method means numerator of the first fraction multiply with the denominator of second fraction, and denominator of first fraction multiplied with the numerator of the second fraction. See here, 6 3s are 18 and here 4 5s are 20. If you observe these two products, the product on the right hand side, that is 20, is greater than 18, that is 18 is less than 20. So the fraction on this side, 3 upon 4, is less than 5 by 6. Isn't it easy?
Yeah.
See next, 4 by 7 and 8 by 13. Again see, numerator of the first fraction multiplied with the denominator of second fraction, and denominator of first fraction multiplied with the numerator of second fraction. Now see, 13 fours are 52, and 7 8s are 56. Understood? 13 4s are 52 and 7 8s are 56. Again see, 52 is less than the 56. That means this 4 upon 7 first fraction is less than 8 upon 30. Okay, so in this way compare the remaining two examples. Here we have practice 5.9 is completed. Tomorrow we will see next practice, next concept. Okay, so hope you have understood all the examples from this practice. If you have any doubt in this, please put forward. Okay, so thank you for today and have a nice day.